अस्सलाम वालेकुम क्लास 7। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट न्यू चैप्टर स्टीफन हॉकिंग अ ट्रू इंस्पिरेशन। इट इज गिवन ऑन द पेज नंबर 121 ऑफ योर बुक। दिस ब्रेव पर्सन इन हिज कॉलेज ईयर्स हॉकिंग वॉज अ टिपिकल टीनेजर। सो दिस होल चैप्टर इज बेस्ड ऑन द लाइफ ऑफ स्टीफन हॉकिंग, लाइक हु वॉज ही, what kind of man he was, and how he became a true inspiration to other people, to other generation. This brave person in his college years, Hawking, was a typical teenager. He would do everything that boys of his age do, playing with machines, taking interest in games and dances, and not taking the syllabus seriously. So he was same like the boys that are present today. He was busy with his machines, he was interested in games and dances, and he also did not take the syllabus seriously. Like, as you know, today's boys also do not take the syllabus seriously. Yet people around him never doubted his potential of a true genius. But the people around him, they never doubted his potential means ability of a true genius. मतलब लोगों ने कभी उन पे ये शक नहीं किया कि वो एक genius इंसान नहीं है. This person grew up to be one of the most renowned and respected scientists of our time. And as the time passed, he grew up to a very renowned and respected scientist of our time. Renowned means बहुत जाने पहचाने, बहुत मशहूर. Stephen as a boy. Now in this paragraph we are studying the life of Stephen when he was a boy. Stephen Hawking was born in 1942 in Oxford, England. The day marked the 300th death anniversary of another iconic astronomer, Galileo, a fact which has been a source of pride for Hawking. Both his parents were Oxford graduates and respected scholars. So Hawking was born in 1942 and it was the 300th death anniversary of Galileo. Then both the parents of Hawking were graduate from Oxford University and they were also respected scholars. Scholars, those who have great knowledge in a particular subject, they are known as scholars. He has two sisters and one adopted brother as well. Their family has been quite an intellectual one. Intellectual means that their family was so intelligent. A close family friend described Hawking as eccentric. They would all eat dinner in silence reading a book. So eccentric means abnormal, strange. So a close family friend described Hawking as eccentric means he described Hawking as an abnormal person. They all eat dinner in silence reading a book because they all eat dinner while remaining in silence and they keep on reading book. They lived in a poorly maintained but large house and owned an old London taxi for the family car. Stephen was always considered bright, though as a boy he never scored well in his class. Stephen ko ek bright student mana jata tha, but he never scored well in his class. He was not a good scorer in his class. However, he had a great interest and talent for activities outside the class. And like other boys, he was also interested in the activities outside the class. He loved board games and created new games with his friends. His love for science and the sky was evident even at a young age. So he was greatly in love with science and the sky from his young age. Stephen as an Oxford and Cambridge scholar. Now we'll study the life of Stephen when he was an Oxford and Cambridge scholar. Griffin began his Oxford days at the age of 17. When he was of 17 years, he started his Oxford days. Initially, he was bored and lonely. Means at first, in his university, he was bored and lonely. But later, he began to be a part of the college activities. But then he started taking part in the college activities. He enjoyed dancing, classical music, science of fiction, and became popular as a lively and witty college member. So then he started enjoying dancing, music, science, and then he also became popular as a lively and witty, means lively and clever member. However, during this time, he would not dedicate as much time to his studies as the college curriculum required. And because of all these things, he was not able to give as much as time the college course required. During his finals, Stephen was required to have first class honors degree to pursue his PhD in cosmology. Cosmology, the study of astronomy, is known as cosmology, from the University of Cambridge. But he ended somewhere on the border of first class and second class. His result depended on an oral examination. He was concerned during the interview day, but when he was asked about his future plans, he replied, "If you award me a first, I will go to Cambridge. If I receive a second, I shall stay in Oxford. So I expect you will give me a first." And he did get his first class degree from Oxford. So when Stephen was giving finals in his university, so first class degree was required for doing PhD in cosmology. And at last his result was dependent on the oral examination. Then on the interview day, when he was asked questions, he replied, related to his future, he replied that if the interviewers will award him first, he will go to Cambridge, or if they would award him second, he shall stay in Oxford. So he expected that they will award him first. And by saying this, he got the first class degree from Oxford. In October 1962, Stephen began his studies from Trinity Hall, Cambridge. So in October 1962, Stephen started his study in Cambridge. Stephen the Fighter. Stephen was still at Oxford when he began to have health issues. Now when he started, when he was still in Oxford, he started to have some health issues. He would trip and fall occasionally, and his speech began to slur. He started speaking unclearly, and he would fall occasionally. This type of issues started beginning in Stephen Hawking. When he was 21, he was diagnosed with amyotrophic lateral sclerosis. Amyotrophic lateral sclerosis, ALS. So this is basically a health condition in which the nerves controlling the muscles stop functioning properly. So this disorder developed in Stephen Hawking, in which his nerves were not controlling the muscles properly. The doctors told the Hawking family that Stephen had two more years to live. The family was devastated and Stephen became depressed. And the doctors told Hawking family that he only had two more years to live. By hearing this news, whole family got very disturbed. They were shocked and Stephen got depressed. He suddenly felt that there was no point in continuing with work or studies. And he started feeling that all the work or studies are of no use now for him. Once when Stephen was in a hospital, he witnessed the passing away of a boy suffering from blood cancer. So one day when he visited hospital, he saw a passing away of boy doctors who were suffering from blood cancer. So he compared his life to dead boys and felt his situation was rather tolerable. So he thought he then compared his life to dead boy's life, and he thought that his life is little tolerable, means bardash ke kabil. Then another day during his illness, he had a dream of him being executed. And then another day, Hawking saw a dream of his death. And suddenly he realized that he is still alive and there is still a lot more to do and achieve in his life. And then he realized that he is still alive and there are many things to do more in his life, and there are many things to achieve in his life. Eventually, the fighter spirit in him brought him out of his depression, and this type of a spirit just took him out from his depression. Stephen began working on his thesis again, and he started working on his thesis again. He married Jane Wilde, a language undergraduate whom he met before he was diagnosed with ALS. Regarding this development in his life, Stephen said that it gave him something to live for. He completed his thesis on black holes the same year and obtained his PhD. So, like this, he completed his PhD also with so much stress and with so much of this hope. He still did not give up, and he tried his best and he obtained his PhD. The making of a scientist. While his health began to worsen, the genius in him came out of its shell. When his health condition started becoming worse, the genius hiding inside him was coming out. He began to research on various aspects of the universe and its working, fate of stars and the creation of black holes. So, with the worse health condition, he started to research on the universe, different stars, creation of black holes, and the different things that are related to our universe. Along with the Roger Penrose, he expanded the ideas and theories from his doctoral thesis on space and time. Then, along with Roger Penrose, he gave some ideas and theories on space and time. In 1974, Stephen came up with a groundbreaking theory that black holes are not the dark, empty spaces in the universe that we believe them to be. He theorized that they emit radiation. His theory was controversial in the beginning, but by late 1970s, it began to be widely accepted. Sorry class, I forgot to turn the page, but I am now on the heading is The Making of Scientist, and it's second para, 1974. Okay, 1974. In 1974, Stephen came up with the groundbreaking theory that black holes are not the dark, empty spaces in the universe that we believe them to be. So Stephen started searching on that black holes, and he then came up with a theory that those black holes are not empty spaces, but they emit radiation. And at first his theory was controversial, but then controversial means it was not very publicly common, but then in 1970s everyone started accepting his theory, and Hawking radiation became popular in the world of theoretical physics. At the Himmel Society, Hawking interrupted a lecture by renowned astrophysicist Sir Fred Hoyle to let him know that he had made a mistake. When asked how he knew there had been an error, Hawking replied, "Because I have worked them out in my head." So he was so intelligent that he interrupted a lecture who was being delivered by a renowned astrophysicist. Stephen Hawking, the scholar. Hawking wrote numerous books. A new world of awards, recognitions, titles, and celebrity status opened to him. While all this was happening, he was getting increasingly ill. He was completely dependent on a wheelchair. His speech was beginning to get slurred. And in 1985, he lost his voice completely to a surgery. So, Hawking wrote a number of books and he got so many awards. He became a celebrity, and but his illness also increased so much that he became dependent on wheelchair. Without that, he was not able to walk, and his voice got completely slurred, means he was now completely unable to talk, and then his voice was lost. In 1986, a computer program was created for him, which enabled him to talk by selecting words on a computer, which would then pass through a speech synthesizer. A speech synthesizer is an instrument. Now, he did not need an interpreter. Hawking kept on working, and in 1988, he published his best-known written work, A Brief History of Time. Then within 1988, he published A Brief History of Time. In this book, he shared his ideas of cosmology in a simple way which appealed to the general masses. He wanted the masses to also have an understanding of his theories. He explained even the highly complex concepts as simple as possible. He also published another book titled The Universe in a Nutshell, with much simpler explanations and illustrations for his theories. So he started publishing books related to universe, in which he shared his theories related to cosmology, which means study of astronomy, study of universe. He even wrote several books for children along with his daughter Lucy, so that the complex topic of cosmology is accessible to children as well. So he started writing books for children as well to make the cosmology topic very clear and obtainable to children as well. Both Stephen and Lucy worked together to debunk the idea that scientists can work only in labs wearing the white coats. To just change the idea that scientists can work only in the labs. They want the masses to believe that science is everywhere and within everyone's reach. And he wanted to make sure that people believe that science is everywhere and it could be reached by everyone. A gifted inspiration. With so much accomplished and proved, one would associate Hawking to be an autograph signing celebrity. However, his children describe him to be a modest person who enjoys playing board games with them. Timothy, Hawking's youngest son, still feels challenged by his father's competitiveness at chess. So his youngest son Timothy was really challenged by his father's competitiveness at chess. Father and son share a passion for motor car racing and often enjoy watching races together. So Stephen has spent a good time with his family also. Today, Stephen Hawking is an established name in the world of physics. And now in the world of physics, the name of Stephen Hawking is so popular. His challenging life requires 4 domestic helps on shift basis. He uses a technical aid for his transportation and traveling, as well as a stylist for his public appearances. But his daughter Lucy describes their family a normal one. So his life was so challenging that he uses different things for the different requirements of his life. Like for transportation and traveling, he used different technical things, and then a stylist to appear publicly. They would sit together and discuss what meal to be cooked on Christmas and what color the kitchen would be painted. So they were a normal family, as they discuss about the meal together. They discuss about the color together. This is the man whose ideas have made way for futuristic science and inspired millions of bright minds, yet so down to earth in his conduct. What is an image of a truly gifted human being if not this? We wonder. So at last, we are questioned that what kind of a truly gifted human being could be if not this? Because Stephen Hawking has so many problems, and despite of those problems, he did not give up and he fighted with his life, with all the problems, and he got all the success. He achieved all the goals of his life. So we must learn from his life, and the chapter is completely completed. Kindly complete the copy and bookwork from the given presentations. Thank you, class.